Hello, welcome back to Isometric Outward. No, I'm just joking, but to be honest, I think I love the game more and more because even though it's grindy and you're supposed to play it with a group, the more you play, the more it makes sense. So I just reached tier 3 Warhammer or Great Hammers, and the game feels a little better now because it feels like my HP is going down. The shield is very good for tanking, but not good for damage. Let's wrap up that thing. I'm not sure what. Oh, I almost got the night flower. So if you're wondering how to use the treasure detector, well, you just build a lot of them, and by a lot I mean about 10 per map, because you don't really get a precise location of the treasure. What is the treasure? The treasure is the treasure chest. How many treasure chests are in the map? Well, there are 3 of them on this map. Maybe you'll get more on the other planets, but it will randomly point one of these ones. So for example, if I will beat the detector over here, it's like plain spin the bottle, except you get many rewards instead of possibly germs. And it will show you. So you have one cave and probably 2 camps where you'll find the challenge chest. Now, it's kind of randomized. I think this will always be a challenge chest inside a cave, and one of the chests inside of the camps will be a secret one. And the cave is also kind of randomized. You might get one of these nature caves, or you might get one of the... what was it called again? The ancient vault caves. Ah, to be honest, you don't have to destroy everything in one go. And you get chitinous shell from them. So I suspect many of these resources will be much more useful later on. As you can see, it's shells, but also meat and also the hide. Yeah, that can get a little annoying. Yeah, this is much better. I think the damage we deal now is much more stable, because beforehand we used to do a lot of damage with this skill, and now we don't do as much damage. Well, I mean, we didn't do as much damage with every attack because it was super boring. So I also upgraded all of my gear to tier 2. So as you can see, we have the rings, the amulet. The amulet also will give you skill power. So it might be related to skill power as well. And you remember, you need coal to smelt the iron ore. Because I'm using the Warhammer, it's just much better for me to round up everyone and then kill them in one go. I really am scared of those spores because they look like they could deal that amount of damage. But I think that's just a bug. So we're not really dealing that much more damage, but I think it's more stable damage overall. Not just burst damage. Sadly, also I have about 300 less shield, because the shield gives you shield, imagine that. It's in my chest in the base. And look at how many resources we have. I think I'm beginning to love this game more and more. So yeah, I wanted to show you the cave level, and then we'll fight the boss, and I'm not sure if I can defeat it or not. We'll just have to see. Well, before I activate the chest, let me get all of the coal. You only get one coal. You might think, well, that's too little coal. Well, yes, in a way it is not a lot of coal. So that means you have to upgrade our tools, because if you upgrade our tools, you might get even a better type of coal, epic or legendary. And besides, I mean, we probably got about 10 or 15 coal already. Sadly, this area is so small we cannot do anything. Okay, let's just ignore it. Oh wow, that's a lot of damage I'm taking. Oh, if that hits me, I'm dead. Yeah. What? He didn't die. I guess I have to balance my damage output and my defenses a little better, because right now I feel like I'm doing that. Lots of damage, but I'm not surviving damage fast enough, or just enough damage. Okay, so I guess I need more gear, more stuff, and faster. Probably to do the next mission I'll need to again increase my gear and some other stuff. Yeah, so probably the best choice if you're playing alone would be the shield and the warhammer, not the great hammer. Also, use a lot of these, because I think you get a lot of them anyway, so... How many do you get? You get 15 per craft, so 1 tier, 4 tier 1 herbs and... Okay. You get the idea. You get 15 of these, so craft a lot of them. Also make some soup if you want, but the soup is not so weight. Let's not forget our tent. Now, to be honest, I think all of this will be useful much later. All of these items, like the grenades, the crystals, the catalyst and all of the other stuff. I think I'll have to play with them after the mission, but for now let's just kill the boss, because you have to kill a boss and it'll be super annoying. From what I know, all of the chests have more or less the same things. So you basically need to get the glowing mushrooms, the tier 3 crown trees, I don't know if it's not out of your way, the herbs, and probably some of the plants as well, and that'll be enough. Probably... Yeah. No, thank you. A deer? Yeah, that's anything but a deer. Sadly, there are some problems with the... Oh, that's a lot of plants and berries. I don't want to do it, but I guess I need to do it. So, you also have to think of them as consumables. For example, what is consumable? Well, I think of the tents and the fireplaces as consumables as well. Also, we need a lot of food. I think we have to eat and drink every 5 minutes or so. And you might think, well, that's not a lot. Well, it's not a lot, but you don't want to wait until you get to the lowest point, so I guess you'll just waste some food and some water on that. Because you'll eat out of habit. Yeah, probably a lot of people say that, I eat out of habit. No, not worth fighting them. Yeah, I wish you'd fix the FPS, the optimization and some other things. It really looks like games have so... Such bad optimization these days. I can kill this guy basically in 1 second. It says deer, but it doesn't look like a deer to me, especially that tiny weird scorpion tail. I'm really curious, can I just... I cannot jump over the log with the skill. That would have been great. Yeah, keep in mind, I'm not really playing the planet just to farm right now or just to do the quest. I'm trying to showcase more of the game and I'll have to farm off camera. Probably I'll have to farm 1 hour or more. Ha 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 So this is annoying because this is more like a dance than a real fight. Just have to wait until he summons the monkey, then use your R skill. Oh, you can interrupt that skill, that's nice. Now the monkey is healing. Okay, so the monkey can either get bugged or something, because last time I was fighting him, I couldn't lower his HP more than a certain point, so the fight might either get bugged and he gets healed no matter if there are no monkeys healing him, or you just might need more damage. So don't worry about it, you can go back to your base and redo the mission.
There are no traces of our people here. Apparently, it was a false trail.
Monster lair. Well, that's not better. I think I want to stay over here. At least it's safe. I guess we should just go to the monster lair. I'm not sure what Elo is used for. Probably Slater. But I guess I should get more of it, but I feel like I have a lot of it and it's only tier 1. Same for him. So, a resource you really need is the crown tree. Tier 3 wood. You'll need a lot of it. Also wish the enemies would attack each other. For example, the deer could attack. Oh, and it's night time, I might get a nightmare spawn. Well, that's why I keep getting a lot of the glowing mushroom ointments. I guess it's worth doing this. So as you can see, I'm getting tier 3 leather hide. I'm getting tier 3 wood, and I'm just collecting all of the healing stuff. And also a lot of wood, because wood is always going to be important, because again, you have consumables like the tent or the fireplaces. And you should always open your map in case there are some fragments here and there. The hollow tier 3 is super creepy. Oh, this is the chest. Okay, that's very annoying. So, some of these enemies can have a lot of AoE abilities. I think the developers just should have made the game for single player. That's so annoying. They could also show you your death location. Now, to get to that point, I'll have to see where this points. Oh, okay, it's over there by the chalice. Okay, but before we go there, we need to sleep. Also, eat a little bit, drink a little bit of water. I know it's annoying, I think it will get better over time, but for now we just have to do all of these repetitive things. Yeah, there's just too much AoE, and as you can see, you can die very easy. Especially once you reach tier 3, maybe in tier 4 or 5, it will be different if you are better prepared, but... Sickle, I need a sickle because mine broke. Where is my broken sickle? A void element. Nice. I didn't know those existed. This one... Oh no, is this the game where you completely... If you don't repair your tools before they are zeroed out... Yes, that's an annoying mechanic as well. You need to carry copper ingots with you. call this a little bit unfair because look at how many enemies were just in this general area. What exploded? That was a lot of damage, yeah. Try to use those grenades a little more often. I mean, you can use it right now, it's a little hard. Oh, it just does 1000 damage. Well, that's not a lot considering I can do that damage with a special skill. Huh, okay. I'm sad, I broke my tools. Okay, so note to self, always carry with you copper ignits and this thing, tier 2 wood planks. This is the secret chest. I think the loot will always be roughly the same, so don't worry about the loot itself. Well, I cannot resist a good glowing mushroom. It's actually good that developers give you an option to not, you know, use the torch, because this is a two-handed weapon. I can no longer carry the weapon and the torch in my hand, so I have to use this one. I may have to use the glowing stuff. Oh, I have to go over here to the lair. Okay, that's not a problem. And look at that monkey. It fell under the screen. Oh no, I need a sickle. I forgot that as well. Okay. Man, this guy was having a moment. So this is a much better skill for damage than the shield hit. Casting time is instant, stamina cost, range of jump. I cleared the camp a long time ago.
So much blood. Those cages. Someone was trying to force the cage door. I wonder what it is. It looks like some kind of totem. Made of metal? But I can't tell what kind. Decorated with some rubbish. But very clearly chosen. This must be a place of worship. Oh, there's a shining stone down there. No, it's not the crystal I was looking for, but there are signs etched into it. Yes, the coordinates. Maybe they will lead me to the missing gatewalkers.
And that's basically the entire mission. So I did this planet maybe 2 or 3 times. I got everything I possibly could get. And this is also the same progress as from the Alpha. This is the exact same quest. So, I guess I just need to farm more. I mean, look at the damage deal, blah blah blah. Oh man, I just wish this game would have been a single player one, because it feels like the co-op is needlessly added to the game, and it will either make it easier or harder depending on who you play with, when you play it. I'm kind of against co-op games because if you're playing with someone else, you'll have a different game experience and you'll maybe not even want to play on your own after that. I guess they're just digging. Okay, so I have to do a lot of off-camera farming.
You say some race kidnapped our people to sacrifice
some
them?
Race.
Quick, you must save them.
Well, that was not a lot of. Okay, quick, go over there and kill everyone that moves. Okay, I'll go over there and kill everything that moves and is not human. Oh, we have a secondary mission. Related to the ignition cell.
This is a very interesting machine indeed. Unfortunately, I cannot produce an ignition reaction that would allow it to start.
Yeah, sorry, the voice acting is not too good. Maybe they'll replace the voice acting at some point. So normally now I'd have to throw everything inside the chest, and as you can see I have a lot of materials and tears. So I think this will get super super crowded at some point, because you will not really be able to throw it all away. Plus I have to repair my tools and build other ones that I lost. So we have a forest that is a tier 3. And the sand that is a tier 3. Boss is unknown. Boss is... Maybe someday we'll know the boss. Also you can see what are the produce you'll get, what are the things you'll get. To be honest, I'm not sure why would you go to an ice world just to get the snow? Because you can get all of the other stuff from here as well. So I guess the ice worlds are mainly for quests, more or less. This looks like a huge meat tenderizer. Anyway, see you next time. Bye!